In this video, we are discussing the five number summary calculations with Google Sheets, and this will take you through each of the functions and methods that are needed to calculate these five calculations for a set of data. Let's get started. Alright, so we want to find the five number summary, and the five number summary, first off, represents the minimum, which is the zero percentile. It's easy to think about percentiles when you're thinking of these. And then Q1 is defined as the 25th percentile, meaning 25% of your data is less than the Q1 value. Median is the middle value, or the 50th percentile. Q3 is the 75th percentile. And the maximum is the 100th percentile, meaning every data value is below it. Now, when you're trying to find Q1 and Q3, it can really vary depending on what procedure you're using, what method you're using. I'm going to show you one method, and just keep in mind that the method that I'm about to show you, it really varies from textbook to course, and so. Anyways, yeah, we'll look at this one method that we'll be using in this course. Okay, so now to find the minimum, there's a couple different methods in how to find this, some different functions. You can use what's known as the quartile function, or you can use the minimum function. I'm going to stick with the quartile function, and the reason for this is because the quartile function can, the same function can be used to find the minimum, median, and maximum. Not Q1 and Q3. You can find Q1 and Q3, but we're not going to do it with that method. It's just not the way we're calculating it. It will be very close to what we'll find, but anyways, let's get into this. So we want equals, and we'll start. So I'm just going to type the function in here. So I'm going to start with apostrophe, and then equals core. And the reason I'm writing an apostrophe is because this is an actual function. This is just to show you what I'm typing in here. So this is quartile, and then I'll put the data in, and then I will put in, to represent minimum, it's the zero quartile. Like this is Q1, this is Q0. So this is minimum's like Q0, Q1 is Q1, median is Q2, then Q3, then Q4. So we'll select the data, comma, zero for minimum. So I'm going to show you really quickly, and we can quickly find the median. And we'll just change this to a 2. And then the maximum, simply, as I mentioned, this is the fourth quartile. Now, keep in mind, I'll put this in here, that we, I'll address it in a little bit, but we could put a, the same thing with 1 and 3 here, but it's not what the method we want to use. I'll show you how to find Q1 and Q3 in a second. So what, I'll show you how to find minimum first. So quartile, and then you'll select the data. And then you'll select the data, comma, zero. So that represents the zero quartile. And that's 20. So let's center align all these. Okay, and then Q1, we'll get to that in a second. Median, we'll do the same thing. And if I'll just type it out again. Quartile. We'll select the data and then put in 2. And then we have the maximum. That's equals quartile. Select the data again and put in a 4 in here. Now, so we found the minimum, median, and maximum so far. Now, let's just visualize this and see where this is appearing in the set of data. And so what we want to do is we want to select the data. And we want to go to data, sort, sheet A, or the range A to Z. Okay, so now this is sorted in order from smallest to largest. And we can see that the smallest number is 20, that's the minimum. The maximum is 60, the largest value. Now there's an even number of data values. There's 18 data values. So the median is going to be shared, is essentially going to be shared between two different values. There's two middle values since there's an even number. And that occurs at the 9th and 10th data values. Okay? And to find the median, what you would do is you would find you would take the average of those two data values, and you would get 40.5. Now this leads to I'm going to go ahead I'm going to bold the top half of the data values, and let's underline them too. How about that? Okay. So this is the top half, bolded and underlined. The bottom half of the data values is just left alone. And so now what we're going to do is we're going to find the median, Q1 and Q3, we want to find the median of each of these halves of data values. So to do this, we would First, look at the top half, the smallest half of the data values, and to find Q1. And so what we would do is we would do equals, and what we can do is equals quartile. Let me go ahead and put apostrophe in here. This is the function. Top half of data, or smallest half of data. And then you would do 2, right? So just to kind of understand this, we're going to look at the smallest half of the data. So let me type this in, quartile. And we're going to look at the, we're going to look at the smallest half of the data, the bold and underlined, and then we're going to put a comma, and we're going to find the median. Now, that's 2. So the median is 32. So notice that that we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. That would, so the median of these 9 smallest half of the data values, the median would be 32, the fifth value. So the fifth value in those 9 would be the median. Similarly, we would look at this list, and the median of these 9 values would be, I'm guessing this would be Q3, right here. And it is possible if the top half or lower half have an even number of values, we would again take the middle 2 and take the average. So we would do equals quartile. Largest half of data, and then comma 2. Oh, let me put a apostrophe in there. Okay, so that would be equals quartile, and we would select the larger half, and then put 2 in there. And we find the median of these data values, which is 48, as I assumed. Okay, so hopefully that makes sense. Here are the functions and the methods you'll use to find each of these values. And I hope this helps.